is Robin S. Gangom, a poet, a bilingual poet. He writes in both English and Manipuri. And then born in 1959, so, and teaches English, okay, in Manipur itself, has been very active in field of literature, particularly of northeast India. And as we are also growing as a nation that can take care of literature from various parts of India. So in this paper, this poem has been included, and inclusion of this poem actually is inclusion of at least one representative voice from northeast of India. And he is he has written this poem in English. What has been he writing on? The issue of freedom, for example, that's a crucial issue. Then sense of self, freedom, culture, politics, love, fellow feeling. All of these are certain themes of his poetry, and the poetry collection that was published in 1988 is entitled Words and the Silence. So we can understand from this title itself, Word and the Silence relationship. Then in 1994, another poetry collection is Times Crossroads, and 2006, The Desire of Roots. And then there is a very prominent essay by him, The Poetry in the Time of Terror. So you see, from these different titles, we can somehow understand what kind of poetry he has been interested into. And if we understand a landscape of Manipur and northeast area, then the composition of the population and religions, their customs, languages, okay, and then rivers, at the same time their flora and fauna. So all, you see, is of course this is one poem, and one can read and explain and go, but we need to locate the poem in that entire area. Why? Because if we know their contours, I mean, how do they look, what are their food habits, what are their clothes, and what are their languages, what is their history. Okay, I tell you, for example, in Manipur, you have a lot of Krishan Bhakti, Krishan Puja. And if you go to Vrindavan, you can find hundreds of people from Manipur visiting here. So you see, there are historical connections and all kinds of, cultural overlappings, exchanges. And this poem is something that reminds us of a phenomenon in India, which is that we, those who belong to rural area or areas which were underdeveloped, so-called underdeveloped, and then later on education, modern education, universities, and then technology, modernity, and progress, all that started. So you see, next generation after 1950s, for example, one generation, this is now second or third generation, that shifted to urban areas or cities, and they all have memory of their past. And most of the memories constitute their childhood, mother, relationship, and how things went out of control. And later, it was not possible for most of them to go back and live there or to revive their childhood or teenage, etc. So we can locate this poem in the broad idea of a nation, modernity, tradition, culture, and various layers of the past and the present, and then how lives of people are affected and impacted by developmental aspects, urbanization, education, and this way.